Welcome back. Okay, despite being a COVID hotspot, we saw York Region now moving into the red zone. So that's significant here because it brings to question a lot of people wondering about region hopping. So what does an infectious disease expert think about this latest development, as well as the very latest on the vaccination front? Joining us again this morning, Dr. Zane Chagla. Always appreciate the time. Good morning to you, Dr. Chagla.
No problem. Thanks for having me.
Okay, so our camera has been standing by literally on the border between Toronto and Peel, and all weekend everyone has said, listen, for somewhere like a York Region to move into a red zone, which is not even the gray, but the red zone, and for a Toronto and Peel to stay in a stay-at-home, what is your take when it comes to mobility and people actually moving across borders and visiting different places?
Yeah, I mean, I think we're all naive to think that people won't move. It's, you know, the GTA is so interconnected. People live in York and work in Toronto. People live in Toronto and work in York. And so, you know, realistically, these precautions, particularly in the control red measures, are meant to decrease capacity, reduce COVID risk, not really dependent on the region itself, but really using some of those capacity limits to make things as safe as possible for reopening. It certainly needs to be watched. But I think obviously the expectation is places like Halton, like Durham, like York will see traffic from Toronto, recognizing that even some of their essential workplaces or even the places that are open in the red framework are staffed by people from Toronto. It's just need to be careful monitoring and reevaluate week to week whether or not it's still an appropriate strategy.
And of course, there is that emergency break, which the province says they can put into place if need be, basically to put us backwards if the case count goes higher. When looking at, I was watching your Twitter feed this weekend, because everyone keeps having the discussion of where these new infections and where the transmission is happening, and a lot of it is happening in workplaces that are deemed essential. So what more do you think should be done or can be done to help control the spread here?
Yeah, I mean, it's a really tough environment, right? You definitely need workplace safety. You need training on personal protective equipment. You need staff to know where they can take a break appropriately and staff to really have the flexibility to go get tested and take days off if they are experiencing symptoms. Recognizing that right now they're not really financially as supported for doing that. You know, there is a response benefit, but that really is under minimum wage and takes a few days to operationalize. It's tough, and I think many of those features need to be fixed as part of this. And unfortunately, lockdowns, the control measures, they're not necessarily going to help these groups moving forward. It really is a group that is not targeted by these and has to be specifically worked on to reduce the risk of COVID for all of us.
Do you anticipate we're going to see some numbers jump now that we've seen some reopening or transitioning, as the Premier likes to call it, in regions? Do you think that we're going to head that way before it gets better?
Yeah, I mean, I think there is going to be some activity seen, and that may be a combination of the variants by increasing physical contacts, by unfortunately these settings, if the variants do get in, they're going to spread much faster in workplaces where people are confined, in shelters where people can't physical distance appropriately. You know, again, it's not necessarily the rise that's the worrisome part. It's the fact that we can respond to it appropriately without necessarily hitting a huge amount of hospital capacity overload and that type of thing. And so, yeah, people can expect a rise. I think people do need to live with the framework right now that they're still living when we were at a stay at home, recognizing just to minimize contacts, minimize exposures to the public.
Really quickly, I just want to get your take on schools. There was a Toronto Star article that did a number of tests and actually found, I guess, a handful or dozens of COVID-19 infections. And that's a good sign, considering that being said, Toronto just went back to school. Peel just went back and York just went back. Do you think that anything more can be done, or do you anticipate these numbers to rise in a school setting?
Yeah, and that's a tricky question. There is some evidence that B117, I think what we saw in Newfoundland, was a big school that did have an outbreak. You know, I think, you know, really, again, having access to testing appropriately, having some baseline of asymptomatic testing, and really some of the controls, like minimizing classroom sizes, are going to be incredibly important moving on. As the community rates go up, unfortunately, school rates may go up with it, and that is something that needs to be monitored as well.
Okay, we will be watching it all. We always appreciate your time and expertise. Dr. Zane Chagla, thank you.
No problem. All the best.
And before we go to break, we are going to activate our storm center because we are seeing a number of cancellations come in here. So there you have it. That is activated because of a number of regions. So if we can bring up the graphics here on what we're seeing for some bus cancellations. Dufferin County, we are seeing transportation canceled here. I believe we have another one that has just come in as well. Simcoe County, also bus cancellations in Simcoe County. So we'll add that one to you as well. Anything that you need to know, by the way, bttoronto.ca/stormcenter. That is the website you're going to go to. That's where we'll continue to compile whatever we are watching here for you. And they are coming in very quickly as this storm continues. So we're going to take a quick break here on Breakfast Television. If I can say break, there we go, quick break, and we'll bring you more.